Welcome back to Truth Hurts Reviews, beer review in beautiful 720 HP. For the past few videos, I have been recording using the front camera of my phone, which I now realize has a crack in it, so it makes it look even more horrible than it should. But this is day three of our beer review little series on the Truth Hurts Reviews. So, we're going to get started with the beer. I'm going to come around here, and this is the beer that we are reviewing today. It is a Smirnoff Ice Watermelon Mimosa, natural watermelon flavored premium malt beverage with natural flavors and certified colors. Beverage and bottled by the Smirnoff Company, Plainfield, Illinois. It is 5.9 alcohol volume, like most alcohol drinks. Nothing special on this can, but you know it's good because it's fucking Smirnoff. So, we're gonna struggle to open this up here. Okay, I just fucked that table up. Don't tell my dad. Hold on, give me a second. I am unprepared. Let me get a lighter so I can continue this shit. Do I not have a lighter? I don't think I do. I do. But the question is do I know how to open a bottle with a lighter like a professional? I don't think I do. I don't think I do. You know what? I could just do that. So, Smirnoff Watermelon Mimosa. Here we go. Look at the bubbles fizz. So you know it's a good beer. I've had Smirnoffs before. I've had the vodka. And I've had these beers. But I don't think I've had the watermelon before. It does have a watermelon-y taste. It's very fizzy, like a watermelon flavored soda. Like a Food Lion brand or a Kroger brand, any type of off-brand watermelon soda, it tastes like that. Pretty good, very fizzy. It still has the alcohol taste. It is nothing like the ginger beer. It is definitely a close second, maybe a third out of all the beers that I have reviewed this week. Smirnoff in general is a good alcohol. They make a very good cheap vodka. And a few other things. They have multiple versions of the Smirnoff ice drink. They have them in 6-packs themselves. They have them in 12-packs. Maybe even 24-packs, like packs of Corona or Bud Light in a glass. But overall, I would have to give this a 9.5 out of 10. The second highest scale, this would have to go in the S tier, along with the ginger beer. So yeah, that is my basic review of this beer. I'm going to take some more sips from it because it is very good. This is, again, another drink that if you have dumbass drug addict parents who don't know how to read. They were raised on the farm, and they were never taught how to read. We could probably sneak this into your shopping cart, and your parents would definitely buy it for you as a soda, because they probably are smokers, and when the cashier asks to ID them, they'll be ID'd, and they'll just give you this when they get home, because they think it's a watermelon-flavored soda. So if you're a smart kid, you want an underage drink with all your friends at the middle school or the high school, and you're like, hey, boys, look my mom and dad bought me yesterday. Smirnoff Ice Beer. Fucking dumbasses. They didn't even realize it was beer. We can get fucked up during lunch now while we're eating our fucking pizza pockets. Then, yeah, go ahead and go for it. But if you enjoyed the video, then please do leave a like, comment, and subscribe. As you can tell, my basement that I am trapped in has gotten a lot more luxurious. Seems like he's letting off of me after he ass-raped me yesterday. Me and him came to an agreement that he will only ass-rape me twice a week. But I still have to get 1,000 subscribers or else he's going to fucking kill me. Which really sucks, but I've really calmed down and I've gotten to the point to where I understand it. 1,000 subscribers or he's gonna kill me, and that's just it. So, yeah, rest in fucking peace.